Hey everybody, thanks for joining us again for another virtual visit here at the New England Aquarium. My name is Nick. I'm here with my friend Bill. Hey Bill.
Nick, hi everybody, how are you?
Bill, tell the people what you do here.
I'm a senior aquarist in charge of the Northern Waters Gallery, which is this on third floor, and all these tanks you can see in front of us.
Amazing. Okay, so we're in front of the last exhibit before you get to the elevator for anyone that has been to the building before and spent time up on the third floor. We call this the Olympic Coastline exhibit, and it features some really cool fish that Bill's gonna actually tell us a little bit about and show us how he feeds. They're called wolf eels. Now, Bill, maybe you could give us like a quick intro about like what this exhibit represents here first.
Sure. This exhibit we kind of designed around the Olympic Coast Marine Sanctuary off the coast of Seattle, Washington. It's a great area, a great sanctuary because there's a lot of life out there. Whales, seals, fish, lots of life, which is a great thing to see. So we try to do our best to replicate some of the environment that you'll find and some of the species that you'll find out there. But we can only do so much in this small space, but we did pretty well, I think.
I think it looks amazing, and I noticed the colors right away, too. It's really vibrant, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. You'll see a lot of colors, which is very different from the New England coast, which is a little brown and whites and little reds. But out here, greens, pinks, purples, it's very beautiful and very colorful out there.
Really cool. Okay, now, wolf eels, are these animals, fish, that you normally see swimming around in this exhibit?
Unfortunately not. The wolf eels are actually really good at hiding. They're about 5 feet long, which is actually a really big eel.
That's
good size. But they like to live in caves, and that's where they feel safe. They kind of make a little home and nest in there, which unfortunately is right kind of back over there behind this rock pile with the anemones. So you don't really ever see them. If you're lucky, they will come out and swim around. You can see them like spread out front. But generally speaking, yeah, you're not going to see them, unfortunately.
Not super visible, but that sounds like normal behavior
That's
for
normal
them.
Behavior for them. That's kind of what they do. So they're comfortable where they are, which is what we're happy about. So they're happy, we're happy.
Okay. So if they kind of seclude themselves in the exhibit, it sounds like you probably have to give them a little bit of specific care, especially when it comes to feeding. What kind of things do you feed wolf eels?
We've tried to feed them a variety of things. We give them clam tongues, shrimp, the shell on for nice nutrients, capelin, things like that, try and mix up a little bit. We used to try and feed them urchins because that's part of their more natural diet as well, but they weren't too fond of it. They didn't really go for it as much. So we kind of stick with what they like.
That's really interesting. They eat urchins, and if you heard Bill mention shrimp with the shell on, they must have pretty strong jaws then.
They do. They have very strong jaws and very strong teeth. So if you ever get a good look at them, they have very sharp, kind of conical teeth that are used for kind of crushing and breaking things like urchins up.
Very interesting. Now, you use a special feeding method to feed the wolf eels as well. Is that right?
We target feed them. We make sure that they actually physically get fed because we can't like just throw food in because the fish, like the rockfish and the surf perch in here, are much faster and more aggressive. So they'll eat the food before we get it to the wolf eels. So we actually put on a stick and put it right in front of their mouth so that they can come out and get it and they can make sure they get fed.
Very cool. And you're gonna see that in a second. Before we let Bill go ahead and do that though, tell the people what your favorite thing about wolf eels is.
There's a lot of good facts about them that I love. Our pair here is actually, we have a male and female and they're a bonded pair. So they have been mating. We have had eggs from them. We haven't had any successful births yet, but we're still hoping for that. So being a bonded pair is a lot of fun. And another fun fact is they actually lose their teeth. Because they crush up the urchins and everything like that, their teeth need to be strong and sharp and really healthy. So every year they'll actually lose their teeth and grow new ones so that way they have nice strong teeth.
I just learned something new. I never knew that there were bony fish that lost their teeth. That's really, really cool.
Yeah.
Super cool. Well, thanks for teaching us a little bit more about wolf eels, Bill.
Absolutely, my
pleasure.
Now
we're gonna take a second to watch Bill do some of the feeding. So stay tuned.